Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Silent Age. This is a funky introduction because of the music in the background, the discotheque music in the background. Anyhow, we are going to address Chapter 8 outside Archon in this video. Having learned of the viral outbreak from Dr. Lambert, Cho must make his way back to Archon on the night before the event to destroy the computer that controls the time machine. But first, he must find a way in. And, he has already met the younger dude that gave him the time machine, the younger version of the dude that gave him the time machine, and he tells him, you know what, thank you for all your service up until now, but you're gonna have to take care of it yourself, and I'm reconfiguring your device. It's gonna take you one day back instead of into the future. It's gonna take you to the past this time around, and you need to go ahead and essentially disable the time machine, is what he said. So that's what we are about to do right now. Alright, so let's go ahead and get this. Look at his strut. Ready to dance, huh? This is a parking meter. I doubt we need to pay for it, but I suppose it would be better if you do. Still warm from the long drive, of course it is. Getting inside Archon is the... Frank always told me these things steal and cheat, like his uncle twice removed. Makes me kind of glad I don't drive a car to work. Sort of. There's a keypad there, and I'm pretty certain that there would be a nightclub. I was not certain of that, but this is going to be. I don't have my access card, besides I need a code to enter after hours, and I don't know the combination, as expected. Getting into Archon is going to be the mess here. No wonder. There's like a quarter there. Please do not press the button. It probably turns off the camera. Please do not press the button. Oh, come on. If they really didn't want people to press the button, why did they put up the sign? There's even a disco ball here. With all the rug syringes and burning branches I've put to good use lately, I'm starting to trust my sense of what stuff might come in handy. And that bad boy is definitely coming with me. I've had weirder things help me through creeps. There's a bartender here.
Right on time. Welcome to the hippest joint in town, my man.
Which is...
We so underground, we literally four steps below the tarmac. Now, what can I do for you?
Actually, I just saw the sign. I don't even know what I'm doing here.
Of course you do. You here because you heard this place was jumping. And you heard right, my man. We got grooves so bad, we make Studio 54 look like off-season fat camp.
It's kind of empty in here.
Yeah, no, I know, man. We literally just opened like 5 minutes ago.
Oh, I see.
They coming. They all coming. Don't you worry. You're going to be knee deep in honeys before you know it. Believe that. Now, what can old Cedric get you?
I don't know. I could use a beer, I guess.
A beer? A beer in here? You embarrassing me here, bub. I got university degrees in mixonomy and mixology. I mix mojitos for the gods.
Just a beer, please.
Man, you really going through with all that, ain't you? Alright, seeing as you're the first patron of the night and all, I'll let you have that one. That'll be a dollar.
A dollar? Jeez. You sure weren't kidding about this being a high-class joint.
Look. I don't jack the prices, kid. This here establishment is just geared towards a more, shall we say, discerning clientele.
I see.
But it's empty.
Yeah. Thank you, man. I got that. I know it's empty, all right? I can see that. I told you, we just opened. Now, you gonna pay for that beer or what?
I think I left my wallet in my jacket. I'll be right back.
Oh, I'll be here.
Nothing that we can pick up from here. This button is something that I want to press. Let me try pressing it here.
Hey, don't you be touching that.
Sorry, just looking.
No, I think we could actually go and put a coin in the parking meter. Just to see what it does. I'm going to check this parking meter as well. It's Frank's own nemesis, Mr. Gobbles Times. Yeah, let's put this quarter in the parking machine. Oh, did not mean to do that, but oh shit, it's all in ruins right now. Oh, okay, here goes 000. All right, no power. Where did you get the code, son? There's a hole in the ground. Doors don't come much more close than this. They even managed to somehow bolt wooden planks out of the steel. Okay, parking meter. Okay, maybe this one has something. Neat, another quarter. So we've got 50 cents right now.
Hang on.
It's a big pile of burnt files and printouts, several drawers worth. From the looks of it, some of the pages are partially readable. And what does it say? October 21st, 1991. We lost treatment today. The only thing more alarming than the pathogen's unprecedented incubation period is the horrific physical toll it takes on the human body. It is a truly gruesome thing to behold. Just under 49 hours after infection, while in quarantine, Friedman snapped his own spine from convulsions. Yikes. As per company protocol, his family will be notified that he died in an accidental fire. A mock urn will be shipped to the funeral director to hand over to the family, and his body will be kept here for further study. I see. All staff memo, as you are aware, the media has been gearing up storm over the past few days. About a highly contagious disease that claimed more than 600 lives in the metropolitan area. Blah, blah, blah. Launched an investigation into identifying the outbreak's epicenter, and unless we act swiftly, we could be subject to nasty and entirely unwarranted PR crisis that could cost the company a lot of jobs, including yours, Joe. All employees of basement level 24, not homesick today, are therefore required to bring all hard copy documentation and research data from their respective projects outside to the back of the building ASAP for terminal destruction. This includes any potentially incriminating magnetic tapes and photographs, too. Under no circumstances are employees to speak with members of the press. Please redirect any queries to our expert PR and legal teams, and with little luck, this will all blow over soon. Remember, loose lips, sink ships. Management. That sounds more like a threat than anything.
Hang on.
Not much left of it. I just quickly want to go back there and get inside the nightclub. And then go to the future. Oh man, this is water. I wasn't expecting that. Cold, so cold. There's a corpse there, probably the bartender. Ick, it's a person. At least it used to be. And there's a cable here. It's a thick, heavy-duty cable. This could come in handy. Probably will. Now, I sort of want to...
Hey, don't you be...
Sorry. Just look.
I doubt that'll work. I can't. Of course you can't. Well, we do have... We need to, like, scrape together a dollar right now. Wait, did I miss something in there? I don't think so. The stairs are missing and the door seems to be nailed shut. Of course it is. Alright, I suppose the only place to go right now is... Mr. Gobble Science. I don't think... Why bother? It's after hours. That's true. I guess the only way we can go is down this hole in the ground then. The cable seems long enough, but I need something to tie it to. Maybe the parking meter. Huh. Hey, I'm pretty good at this knot tying business. Oh heck, I jinxed it. Now that cable's gonna snap with me on it, and I'll die down there with two broken stumps for legs. Yeah, that's not a good knot. At all. There's like a payphone here. Looks like it's been out of service for decades. I mean, it has been 40 years since the apocalypse. There's a hat here. Maybe it has something? Just one quarter short of a dollar. And there's a vent. The grating actually looks a bit loose now that the bolts have rusted. It's loose enough for me to wedge a coin between the grating and the wall, but I can't get enough leverage. I need something stronger. Any of the think are accessible? Apparently not. And there's like a door there. There's also a cable there. The cable is probably used for the welding going on inside the railcar.
Nice.
Another quarter. I've got a whole dollar's worth now. I'll get in there soon. The first subway musician. There's a vent here. There's a draft coming from this vent. I can hear a loud humming inside too. Trap. That creature's fastened to the wall with bolts. I can't use a coin to unscrew it. There's a hat. This guy's probably going to tell us something. Seeing from a blind vet, I may have done a lot of objectionable things lately for the good of humanity and all, but I still have standards. Good. Good, good. There's a power supply here and there's a welder here. Just a moment. Okay, I doubt I can turn off the power supply, but I could probably take the wrench here.
Sir, would you kindly step away from there? It's not safe.
Roger. I'll just go ahead and do that then. It's a welding power supply. Well, I suppose we need to take the disco ball or something. Back to the future, since we have enough money for a beer then. Only to get back to the past. And, yeah, give this guy a dollar. I wonder how the time travel device is still charged.
I've changed my mind. For the money, give me the fanciest drink you've got.
A challenge, huh? Alright, I'll bite. Prepare to be dazzled. One rainbow frosted hot lava slushy deluxe with a twist coming right up.
Okay, it's coming down. I just need to be quick and get it before he sees me. If I get busted for this, I want to go straight to jail without trial. I'd much rather prefer that than having to explain my reasoning behind this in the court.
It is complete. Now, you could just let it sit there for a while, have the layers settle for that smooth sensation. Or you could have it right away and blow out your taste buds with sheer delight. Your choice.
At this point, I am sort of tempted to have it. In real life, I mean.
Whoa. Man, that's... It's like the universe just revealed all of its secrets inside my mouth.
That sort of sounds like a dirty way to put it, but alright. I guess that's it for the drink. Maybe we'll have a little sip.
Sweet mercy. It's like riding sidecar with a unicorn down a mountain of cashmere sweaters.
This is so that you can get drunk.
Oh, mama. That's good.
I doubt one cocktail will be enough, but who knows.
Oh, baby. You're not like the others. We're not hitchhiking anymore. We're riding. Whoa.
Yeah, man, that's enough.
That's...
So, where would we use the disco ball then? Looks like it's been out of service for decades. And that guy died while... Use disco ball with vent. That makes no sense whatsoever. I can't get it to work. Of course you can't. It makes no sense. How would we be able to get it to work? This is a welding power supply, I know. I wouldn't know how, of course. Can I interest you in a disco ball? Good idea. I'll just dazzle him into handing over his tools. That or he'll throw me out on my ass and elbows. My money's on the latter, of course.
For someone who just experienced a total taste revolution, I ain't never seen nobody look so troubled. What's on your mind, brother? You looking like the whole world is just resting on your shoulders.
Well, that's kind of it. It does. I mean, if I fail, that'll be the end of it, you know?
Oh, I know where you coming from, Chen.
You do?
Oh, sure I do. Right now, you're probably asking yourself, how many nights I gotta go through this before I get it right? When do I get to unleash the lion? Do I even remember how? Well, take it from Cedric. You just hit a rough patch is all, man. It ain't the end of the world.
What? No, I'm...
Oh, I read you loud and clear, Mac Daddy. Don't you worry about a thing. When the honeys come in tonight, you just stick to the bar and keep ordering. I got you covered. Tonight is the night, man. Believe that. By the way, and I gotta ask, what's up with them threads, man? That's gotta be the most unique night on the town getup I ever seen.
Huh? Oh, this. Well, I came straight from work, so...
Well, I dig it, Ace. So keep it right up, man. It might just become the next big thing.
It actually might. Now, what the hell am I supposed to do here? Inside the subway car, right? I haven't tried that yet. Dark area? Well, maybe I could use it with this here.
Whoa.
Glittery, no wonder. A screwdriver. I bet this will come in handy. Yes, it will, sir. Yes, it will. This will probably let us unscrew this vent here. No dice, it's fastened to the wall with bolts. If the grating was just a little looser, I may be able to pry it off with a screwdriver though. Alright, in the future it is.
Yes.
It worked! It's all inaccessible right now. There's a big fan here though. And oh boy. Okay. It's inaccessible. How about right now? Between the rusty blades and whatever has been oozing into the water, even if there's a way to get through below the waterline, I'm not risking it. I see. So we need something to get past here. Oh wait, there's a wall here. Hidden behind that guy. I can hear water rushing through the pipe. Did it do anything though? Everything seems to be the same here. It won't turn any further. Everything seems to be the same here, to be honest. Oh, the bar. Right, maybe it takes care of things in the bar. And this guy has a handgun in his hand. He's holding a revolver. It's rusty, but the barrel rotates. I've got all six. No, wait. Five bullets left. One casing is empty. Oh, so it was a death by suicide. I haven't fired a gun since basic training, but this could be really useful. Now, what would we need to fire a gun at? Alright, apparently... I had to resort to looking up a guide online because, well, this guy can't shoot at the fan, but, like, I was assuming that this guy could not shoot through the fan because of the speed at which it is rotating, but apparently if we shoot this with the revolver. That definitely made noise, but, oh no! Oh no, we shot
Hello?
Him.
Is anyone in here? Oh, drat. The muzzle split. I guess this gun was a bit too rusty after all.
And we can just switch this off. That's bad. We shot the time travel guy. What on earth is a rifle doing here? Not much of any use except for this wire cutter. This grating is pretty sturdy, but I bet I could cut through it with the proper tools. Meetings too.
No.
There's blood on the handle.
Blood on the handle. Hello? Is anyone in there? Are you hurt?
Oh no. Finally, some luck, the greeting came right off. Now, here's the thing, I sort of want to just quickly go back and use the wire cutter on the other thing there. Now, while I like the time travel mechanic, phasing back and forth with it is a little difficult. Another bad deed done in the name of humanity. I hope it's worth it. Alright, we can now get the wrench from there. I hope he doesn't mind borrowing his wrench. I'll bring it back before he notices it's gone. No, you won't. No, you will not. Alright. Time to head back to the future. Come on. And of course. Now you can head through it. But before you could not. Alright, vent opening. There's like another vent there and some other things. There's a hatch down there now. It might just be an elevator shaft, I suppose. There, got it open. And I suppose that's how we get into Archon. And that was that from Chapter 8, Outside Archon. The solutions to the puzzles were a little obtuse. And it was complex. It wasn't as simple or intuitive as the previous chapters, so to speak. Personally, I got stuck at one point with the spinning fan and had to look up how to get past that stage. I'm hoping that I will be editing this sufficiently to essentially, you know, correct all the issues correct the continuity. So yeah, anyway, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be continuing the final arc, or rather the final act of this game with Inside Archon, and then the final chapter, of course. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.